الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. I welcome all of you my dear brothers and sisters inshallah today to this subject where we want to discuss the responsibility of the youth in the current scenario. As a Muslim we are aware the global situation. I get these emails, these calls, these messages that our youngsters, our young brothers and sisters are asking, what can I do as a Muslim in today's difficult, rather a very hurtful situation across the globe? Nothing is hidden from you and me. We know the situation of our brothers and sisters in countries like Palestine, in countries like Afghanistan, Iraq, Chechnya, Syria, Burma, and the list goes on. According to one of the UN reports, it says in the last 10 years, more than 4 million Muslims have been massacred to death. As a young man, I can understand how could you and the rest of the youngsters feel about the situation. We want to know what can I and you do in order to make a change for the situation of our brothers and sisters across the globe. For rightly the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the famous hadith, he said, the Muslims, my ummah is like one body. If one part of the body aches, the entire body feels the pain and the agony. So how could it be that I and you claim to be a believer, to be a Muslim, to be part of the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and do not have any regard for the situation of our brothers and sisters across the globe? But the question is, the challenge is, what can I and you do? There are many who would give us various options. Some say the leaders, the politicians, the scholars, the people in the militaries, they should take some action. Yes, these are some of the strategies that are meant to be done. But let us talk about what I and you, as a common man, as a layman on the streets, as a person of a family, as a person who is just a youngster passing out through his degree, his schooling, his high school, can do for the change in this ummah. If we go back to the history and take some lessons from the previous prophets' lives, for example, Musa alayhi salam. Musa alayhi salam was sent to the world's worst oppressor. Yes, that's Fir'aun, the world's worst oppressor. He was an oppressor on the children of Israel, the Bani Israel. He would kill their babies and their children, and they would not even have the right to say a word. They would not even oppose him. Rather, when they have the birth of a child, they would inform the military of Fir'aun, and they would hand over their baby to be murdered, to be dismantled in front of their own eyes. But they made a prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They said, Ya Allah, send us someone who could take us out of this situation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listened to their dua and sent Musa alayhi salam. Now it's very important we see, what did Musa alayhi salam do with Fir'aun to change the situation of Bani Israel? It was the worst oppression that the human history can ever record. And what Musa alayhi salam was commanded to do by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to go to Fir'aun and gently invite him to the obedience and worship of one Rabb, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, in short, Musa gave da'wah to Fir'aun. And you know the whole story, how the situation turned from the Bani Israel to be the subjugated community to the rulers on earth at that time. We come to the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a very similar situation. He is being tortured, subjugated. The Sahaba are being murdered and brutally killed in Makkah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make hijrah along with all the other believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants the city of Medina as a gift to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The whole city of Medina, majority of them embraced Islam. Not only did they embrace Islam, but they invited the Prophet to come to the city of Medina and rule them by the rules of Islam. And all of this happened how? What did the Prophet do in the city of Makkah for 13 years? He did da'watul Islam. He invited anyone and everyone from Makkah and all the visitors from Medina to Makkah, he invited them to the religion of Islam. In other words, in short, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did da'wah and the success was in his forefront. So I would like to come towards the conclusion by reminding my dear brothers and sisters, I and you as a common man, as a normal Muslim, what we can definitely do is invite people to the religion of Islam in order to make a change for the Muslim society across the globe. And who should do this? Especially the youth of this ummah. The Prophet said, the youth are the hope of this ummah. The youth has the energy, the youth has the capacity, the youth has the skills. And we, with the combination with the amalgamation, with working in unity with our leaders, our elders, our scholars, the people of experience, with their guidance, we will be able to be led into a situation where, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how Allah took away the Bani Israel from the oppression of Fir'aun, how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was commanded by Allah to take away the Sahaba from the oppression of Abu Jahl and the people of Makkah. Similarly, by the will of Allah, I and you may be part of that situation where we will be contributing to the change and to the victory that definitely belongs to Islam. I would like to conclude from the two ayats of the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands in the Quran in Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3, ayah number 110. A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas ta'muruna bil ma'roof wa tanhawna anil munkar wa tu'minuna billah. You are the best of the people that have ever been raised amongst humans. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praising us Muslims and saying you are the best of the people that has ever been raised in the human race. Why? Because you invite people to that which is good and you stop people from that which is wrong, which is falsehood. And you say that you believe in Allah. My brothers and sisters, we are praised by Allah for doing da'wah. Just imagine, reverse the situation. We would be dispraised by Allah if we don't do da'wah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Fussilat, Surah number 41, ayah number 33, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who is better in his speech than the one who invites people to Allah and does righteous good deeds and says that I'm one of the Muslims? One last statement from one of the famous poets of the Indian subcontinent, Allama Iqbal. He said, Meri zindagi ka maqsad tere deen ki sarfarazi, main isiliye musalma, main isiliye namazi. He said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his poetry, he says, the purpose of my life is the glory of your deen. That's the reason I'm a Muslim. That's the reason I'm a musalli. So my dear brothers and sisters, the message that I want to give it to you today is, as a youth, as people of energy, as people who want to make a change, and those who are the leaders of this ummah for future, make sure that you put your efforts for the change that Islam is awaiting, for a change that this ummah is waiting for a change that our vulnerable brothers and sisters across the globe who are being oppressed are waiting for. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.